jolt!
Hello, Eivor.
They must be finished now.
The king has called for his best mead, so the talks are concluded. It should be safe to enter.
I'm ready to face the thunder. I will speak with the king now.
Excellent, King Styrbjorn. I will take this proposal to my nephew. I believe he will see the wisdom in it.
Good. It is all I can hope for. May the... May the winds favor your voyage, Guthormr. Eivor, come forward, and explain in plain words why you have willfully disobeyed my commands. Do you mock me?
I do not mock you, King. I mean to embolden you, against your enemies, and your own poor judgment.
You know nothing of my judgment. You know nothing of my plans and strategies.
Sigurd would agree with me.
My son might agree with you, but he would obey me. He knows his place.
Not as well as he knows his father.
Imagine you are harassed by an enemy with warriors that vastly outnumber your own. What profit does open war bring? Would it not be better to work quietly through diplomacy, gaining alliances? Waiting until the day our numbers outweigh our enemies, and our victory is guaranteed.
Do we have any allies to speak of? Or is that your excuse to do nothing?
Your confidence blinds you to so much in plain sight, Eivor. Day and night I toil to forge ties with clans to the north. Very soon you will see the fruits of my efforts. Only then will you understand.
Is that all?
I'm at a loss with you, Eivor. When I took you in as my own, never did I imagine such disrespect from the child of Varin. Your father was a fine man. Just and loyal to me, he died bravely so that we might live.
He died a coward, Lord. A fate I will not mirror.
Why do you carry such a useless burden? Let it go! Think only of the days to come, of your future, and the victories at hand.
My honor has been stained. Until it's wiped clean, I want nothing else.
I refuse to pick at that wound again. But if there is something that can chase these shadows from your thoughts...
Sigurd has come! Down at the docks, his ship is here!
Hey, careful with that one! Eivor!
Sigurd!
Ah, look at you, blood-soaked drinker! What, have you been worrying without me?
Oh, and you, salt-cured Vikinger! I smell the stink of a dozen kingdoms in your beard.
It's just the start. Randvi, my dear wife. Your husband returns. Bringing gifts, and riches to share.
And new friends, I see.
Yes! Basim and Hytham. We met in Miklagard, and they showed me her buried secrets.
We are grateful to Sigurd for his invitation, and eager to pay tribute to your king.
My brother is always very careful with the company he keeps. If you're standing safely beside him, he must like you.
Ah, Eivor. Save the introductions until our bellies are full. I will see my father. Tell him of my time away.
This morning we traded with a ship passing south.
They told us Eivor the Wolf-Kissed was captured by Kjotve's men.
They must have cut the tale short. I killed my captors and recovered my crew. And for that your father scolded me. You know where I stand, brother. Nothing short of war will dislodge Kjotve from our lands. But he disagrees.
I know. I know. Father thinks too much and acts too little. Today that changes. I promise you. By the winter's end, the name Kjotve the Cruel will be a curse on the lips of a drunken fool.
My son, welcome home.
Father.
Tonight we feast and celebrate your return, Sigurd. The tables are laid with barley and lamb, bread and mead.
And no more, I beg you. I want nothing you would not serve a thrall. Let me be the one to honor you. I bring gifts and tales from faraway lands. After 2 winters away, I am full up with both.
Very well, very well. Come inside.
And when we are fat and satisfied, Father, we will talk of Kjotve and his clan, and how we may end their terror, once and for all. He has dogged us too long, shamed us for too many seasons. I know this. Eivor knows this. It ends now.
Yes, of course, when the time is right.
Through Rusland we barreled down the Volga River, raiding as we went, shadowy tribes hurling spears at our ship. At Miklagard, we saw men bedecked in riches as vibrant as the Bifröst itself. And these we took for our troubles, of course. We sailed to Rome, then Africa, past oceans of sand, warriors of all colors, and beauty the eyes must weep to behold. And now I have returned, with riches and glory to share with my family, my friends, my eyes forged Strengir. So take what you desire from my horn. For this is only a taste of things to come. Tomorrow, the Raven Clan starts anew.
Skål, Sigurd.
Skål! And you, Eivor, come. I have something special for you.
Randvi.
Eivor, have you paid a visit to Valka?
I did.
And?
It is not something I can speak on, or wish to.
I understand.
Your bed will be warm tonight, with your husband returned. That must be a good feeling.
It is a different feeling. Warmer, but with less space to stretch my arms and legs.
Are you not happy to see your husband returned?
Of course. But it has been so long he seems a stranger to me. 3 winters we are married, and he has been away for 2.
Can you not rekindle the flame that once burned hot?
When he crawls into bed to warm me, as you say, it will be with farts and honeyed breath.
Ah, we should all be so lucky. Hytham, is it?
Yes, and you are Eivor.
I am. I hope this ruckus does not overwhelm you. We tend to drink and talk at equal speed.
Not at all. The wood smoke from your fire pit does sting the eyes, but the warmth is welcome.
Of course. It must be rather warm where you live.
Where I live changes from week to week, but always I am with my mentor, Basim.
Your mentor? For what cause?
A noble one. A cause as true as the world is old. But let us leave it at that for now.
I understand. But if you hope to stay tight-lipped for the rest of the night, keep clear of Tekla's mead.
Ah, thank you for the warning. It will not be a problem.
You are Basim.
You have a good memory.
And you have no mead. Can I fix that?
Sigurd spoke often of you on our journey, called you his right arm, a celebrated warrior. I am honored to meet you.
Likewise, Basim. And how did you come to meet my brother?
He sat down in Constantinople some months ago to rest and resupply, he told me. But I knew otherwise. Men with eyes that gleam like his are always up to something more.
I think he wished to raid the Hagia Sophia.
That sounds right.
I will not bore you with the details of our meeting. But I liked your brother from the first. I saw something in him that captivated me. As if a forgotten memory of an old friendship had suddenly resurfaced.
He has that effect on people. Enjoy your evening, Basil.
I thought long and hard on a gift worthy of you.
You've snared my curiosity, brother. What is it?
Not yet. Drinks first. To my first night in Fornburg in over 2 winters. It must end with me soaked and wall-eyed, shouting at the shadows of trolls.
And you want me to sail with you on these honey waves?
Yes. You are stuck with me, Dringur. Now drink. Ah, you would put Thor to shame.
Forgive me. On your first day back, I should have let you win.
Gods, you should have let me start.
It is good to have you back, Sigurd.
Yes. I've missed this terribly. When I first met Basin, I regaled him with tales of our homeland. And it was then I felt a heart longing to return at once.
Come.
This brings us to your gift. These excellent men were my shepherds through much of their homeland, the Abbasid Caliphate. They are a clan not joined by blood, but by a common idea. A brotherhood of shadows executing their own form of justice. In my time with them, they shared many of their most hidden secrets, for which I am grateful. And now, I gift one of these secrets to you. A weapon for the finest warrior I know.
Beautiful craftsmanship. What kind of smith makes a weapon like this?
It is less a weapon than a tool. One we have used for centuries to fight injustice and evil.
Mentor, I must protest. This is deeply unorthodox. Our wrist blade is a sacred
tool.
Do
not make a fetish out of cold metal, Haifam. What matters is the mind of the one who wields it. Please, try it on. The blade should ride on the underside of your arm to conceal it from your target.
I have no wish to hide this, and I would rather not make the same mistake you two have. I like it.
This is no mistake. This is a voluntary sacrifice to prove our devotion to...
A good start, Eivor. But you must learn how to use it effectively.
Outside. This is not something for all eyes.
Lead on. This clan of yours, it has a name?
Indeed. But among the tenants, the Valkyrie is a vow to never reveal too much to outsiders. In time, you may learn more. But not here, where the walls and trees may have ears.
I look forward to it.
Here, let me lead you through our most basic techniques.
Wielded with skill and care, our blade delivers a singular killing blow. As you near your target, find your window to strike. Timing is essential. Nicely done.
I have not seen a blade so sharp.
Some targets are trickier than others. Keep that in mind before you strike.
A decent attempt.
Take that one down from the ledge. A perfect strike.
How about a challenge? Leap down upon that target from above.
That's it. Use your surroundings when possible. Strike from that haystack, for instance. Exactly, just like that.
Mentor, does Eivor intend to join us?
Not that I am aware.
Why offer him the blade? Surely we have more...
Hytham. Hush. You wield the blade well. Let us leave Eivor to enjoy his gift in peace. Come.
Eivor, let us walk to the docks and take in the night air. What do you make of my new friends?
They seem generous and menacing in equal measure.
I know what you mean. They have learning, too. They wield numbers and writing as if it were magic. Basim has shown me so much about the world, all of which I will share with you when the time is right. Oh, I miss the smell of this land.
Have you returned for good? Or do you mean to join this Shadow Brotherhood?
Leave all that aside, Eivor. Tonight we are family again. The here and now is what matters. Our kinship, our clan, our glory.
I missed you, brother. Your clear head and your courage. We have not had enough of both in recent months.
You flatter me, Wolfkissed. Keep it up.
From here to Valhalla, I will always be on your side, Sigurd. Always.
This fjord has grown too small to contain me, or I too large. There is so much more beyond these stony fangs that rise around us. England, Ireland, Francia, all greener pastures, ripe for the plucking. Tomorrow, we make new war on Goethe, and reclaim the lands he took from us. And from there, we build a kingdom for us.
I'm with you. Only say the word.
Good. Get some rest, and return here at first light.
The Nordnir have spoken. You will betray
Sigurd. No! This is wrong! That cannot be right! Odin fought against his fate! It can be done!
You will betray Sigurd.
Shit! Kjotve's warriors! Thunin, guide me.
Oh, my eyes. Show me.
I have a bad feeling. Just the three of us. We should return to Knotfall with our report, while we can.
We can bring Kjotve news of the Longsons. Or we can wake him with Sigurd Styrbjörnsson's head. Which is better?
All right. When Kjotve returns, we weigh our next move.
With each day we wait, Kjotve grows strong.
We do not have the men to storm Kjotve's fortress. The losses would ruin us.
The losses have ruined us, father. Until we cut off this serpent's head, it will poison us day by day, drop by drop.
The poison has already polluted our waters.
God save all. What happened?
Spies in our camp. Three men sent by Kjotve to kill us as we slept. I returned the favor.
There, you see? This is what waiting brings. We must answer this insult.
They came from Knotfall, that whaling village under Kjotve's control.
We hid him there. Burn it down before Kjotve learns his spies are dead.
He may have sent more. I can search the village while you round up the crew.
No need. I will send Hytham to search the area. You can rely on him while we are away.
We? Do you mean to join us?
I have not been bred for Valhalla like you, but this will be far from my first battle.
I do not like this, but I will not stop you. Do not lead my son into the same storm that follows you.
Vartu þar þegar Ölvir afhökkvast? Það var gott gaman. Ölvir og glensaði og naut sólar á síðasta degi sínum með hann.
Muni Kúrói á Írlandi kalla það. Sögur segja Danir.
Nei, reyndar að búa við nú höllina.
Your oars!
This wind would fill the sail!
Warriors!
Sail!
Bring!
That's the wind!
When I was away, far from these frozen
sail
shores,
out.
Wondering if I should ever see home again, I grew afraid. Afraid I would not return in time to see Kjotve's end. Afraid I would not. in a drift of snow! But here I am, home in time to join those I have missed, those I love, in this glorious fight. Today we seize Noctval from Kirkby. Tonight his heart will pulse with worry. Tomorrow it will burst from fear. He will beseech the gods for aid, for they will be deaf to his cries. And soon the Raven Clan will feast on his death. You know these isles best, Wolfkist. Lead us to victory.
I will show the way, but you must lead us there.
Oh, Eivor. I missed having you at my side. How I wished I could have taken you along on my travels.
Styrbjörn did not trust fate for both our lives.
You have no reason to fear. Together, we are unstoppable.
Need your eyes.
Supply wagons! We should destroy them!
Burn!
Wear you out, meeting!
Please do! Break you!
Ravenclan! You reap a bloody harvest. Who are you, Gester? Name yourself.
I know his face. He met with your father not long ago.
I did, indeed. I am Guthorm, uncle to King Harald of the North. I speak for my nephew when there is need. This is not King Harald's land. Why does he send warriors so far south? You may ask him yourself, my lord.
Thank you, uncle. And you are Sigurd of the Raven Clan, is that right? Son of the wise King Styrbjörn.
I am. And you are standing on his land, King Harald. Land we have reclaimed with blood and steel.
That I see, and I honor it. For I have not come to war against you, but for you, at the request of your father.
The canny wolf. Was this the plan he spoke of?
I offer my support. With my warriors, your Raven Clan can take Kjotve's fortress and settle this rivalry for good.
This is good news, Eivor. The Wandering King will tip our fortunes.
Why risk your men to help us, King? Have you a stake in this fight?
This war between Kjotve's clan and your own has long simmered on my southern border. I wish to see it put to rest. There would be no peace while Kjotve lives. But there's much agreement between your father and me.
This blood feud runs deep, King Harald. We welcome your help, but I must lead the charge.
I see. Is this a question of honor?
It is. Many winters ago, Kjotve broke an oath to our fathers. He betrayed a friendly peace and slaughtered many.
I understand. Sigurd Jarl will lead the assault against Kjotve and his clan. Give him full command of my ships and my warriors. When your victory is in hand, Sigurd, find me at Alrekstadir, and we will celebrate together.
Our men will gather at Florli, near the mouth of the fjord northeast of here. Will you join us? Hold a moment. You captain our longship, Eivor. Meet us there, and we will claim Kjotve's head for the gods.
Brother, I have waited too many years for this day. When Kjotve stands before us, give me the final blow.
You will have it, Eivor. You deserve it.
Eivor! Give us a hand! Harald is generous with his troops. More than I would be.
I cannot fathom his game. He's either a young fool, or deceptively wise.
Whatever his reason, I have a good feeling this war is near its end.